14 years ago, the RTI law was passed. Since then, it has grown to be one of the most popular people's laws in the country. More than 70 lakh people a year use the law. It has raised and brought out all kinds of corruption and malfunction and malgovernance. Almost 80 people have been killed in trying to use the law because vested interests are hurt. And yet every single government has tried to amend it and people have resisted. Unfortunately, this year, the government succeeded in ramming through amendments through parliament without any consultation at all. These amendments weakened the backbone and the strongest part of the RTI law, which was the information commissions, who can make sure that information can be extracted from the highest office and given to the citizens. Those information commissions, by weakening them, the RTI law itself is sought to be weakened. But people will fight back. People demand for transparency and openness is a birthright. And even before the law, people were asking for it. After this law, people are still continuing to file RTIs, chase it. And we are running a campaign to make sure that RTI does not die, but by using RTI, we will actually save RTI and strengthen accountability. There is also the whistleblower protection law and the Lokpal law, which was passed in 2015. And yet we find that 5 years later, this BJP government has not only weakened the RTI law, it has refused to notify the whistleblower protection law. Those 80 lives that have been lost are on its head. And today, people, they are exposed for showing that they really actually don't care about those people who are fighting against corruption, who are fighting for better governance, who are fighting for democracy. They want to suppress them. And on this anniversary, we will once again get together to say that we will fight for RTI. We will fight to make sure that it is properly implemented. And we will fight to make sure that these amendments are replaced by an amendment that makes it a constitutional body, the Information Commission, so that they can extract information from whether it's the Prime Minister or the President's office or from anyone else, lowest to highest, and give it to the people.